In this video, we will walk through how to use Jamboard as an assignment tool for students or as a teaching tool for teachers. So Jamboard, you could think of as a big whiteboard in a sense. For this assignment, I said create a Jamboard of your character analysis and a storyline for your movie viewing assignment. Go to the link below. So Jamboard is a Google app or site, essentially, just jamboard.google.com to go to. It is linked with your Google Drive, so anything you do in Jamboard automatically syncs and stores in that Google Drive, and students have access just by being signed on in the top here, as well as teachers. In order to create a new board, you press that plus button. You have a few tools on the side. You have pen, marker, highlighter, or paint, as well as a few colors. An eraser here to erase anything you do. The select mouse button will let you move things around. This is to add sticky notes and to add images, either uploading a file or through Google search. Here is a laser. If I was in this board with more than one person and I wanted to draw their attention to something, I could point it out using a laser and it just disappears. To add a sticky note, you can change the background to any color. Press save, click out of it. I can then click on it, rearrange it, make it larger, turn it, duplicate it, or even delete it. I can also add a sticky note with no background. This just makes it appear to be clear. So if I wanted to add in a background, such as loose leaf, I could do that. I can also use this as a math tool, so I could add in a background like this and use my pen option to draw shapes with my students. That's not a very nice shape, but you get the point. Or I could add in a grid and do some graphing on here as well. Adding my X, whoa, and my Y. Anytime I want to make a new page, I can click on a new page and go through it that way, adding in lots of different things. Now, the desktop version is quite limited. There are many more options if you are using any sort of mobile device. You would just download the Jamboard app and then you can do a plethora of things. However, I can click back and I can see different jams that I have made just on the computer. And just by importing images and using sticky notes, I'm able to do some fairly simple stuff. I could even teach math through this by importing a picture of a math lesson or a math question. And when I'm ready to submit it, it's all saved in my drive, making it quite easy. I can also share any of these with other people. By clicking on that share button, I could collaborate and have other students or other teachers on the same board with me working at the same time. Now we'll go through what this would look like using an iPad and the different capabilities there. This video will go through Jamboard and how to use it as a creative way to connect with students. If a teacher has assigned an assignment with Jamboard, they could actually attach the link to creating a Jamboard right within that assignment. Once the student opens up the assignment, they'll be able to see the link, click on it, and they'll be brought to a new Jamboard. They'll press the plus button, which will bring them to a new screen. From here, they have lots of options. Carrie's assignment said that I needed to create a character analysis. So I can use sticky notes, change the background of them, write various things, and put them anywhere on the board. for the purpose of this video, I'll do one on Olaf. So as I continue to add in sticky notes, I can make them larger or smaller, place them in various spots, tilt them, turn them. Just by clicking on that plus button, I can add in more, changing the color of the background, and clicking and dragging, and using two fingers to resize. Then I can click the plus button and Google search images, bringing in whatever image I want, again resizing with two fingers to make it larger or smaller. The three dots will allow me to duplicate my image if I want or delete it. I can click on the drawing tool and use assistive tools to make cleaner lines, to have something go from drawing to text, or even to create an image for me. In this case, I'll use the cleaner lines, adding in more sticky notes to add a little bit about my character. I can start a new page at the top by clicking on Next Slide. It brings me to a new drawing. From here, I can actually go in and I can use tools that'll organize this page for me. When I import one of those tools or stickies, they call them, I can click on it and move it anywhere on my screen. I can make it larger, smaller, zoom into my screen, or zoom into the image. And when I have them where I want them, then I can start populating them with different things. I could draw right in those images, I could write within them, add stickies, add images from the web or from my device. I'm going to click on the assistive drawing tool, which allows me to draw something and then it makes suggestions as to a drawing that would match what I'm trying to draw. So since I'm not an artist, as you can tell by my tree, it recognizes that I was trying to draw a tree and gives me some other options. I can do this for multiple things, including even something like trying to draw a house. Using two fingers, I can resize it, or I can go up to the three dots and duplicate it, moving it anywhere on the screen that I choose. Starting a new page, I can actually access any content from my drive as well. So I could bring in a slide presentation and move it anywhere on the screen, making it larger or smaller. I could also import a math equation and then write right beside it and solve the equation for my class. When I'm ready, I can go back to the main screen. Here's an example of a different character analysis I did, and even a timeline of a story. Very simple to use. Then I can head back to my classroom. I can swipe up on work, press add attachment, go into my drive, and just search the title of my Jamboard, since it saves automatically into my Google Drive. Click on it and press mark as done. Then I can turn it in and my teacher can see my board.